See, last class I told you that some clearances are required to start any project. I will tell you there are about 4 steps involved before implementation of project on construction of seaport and other marine works. Other marine works include seawater intake system, outfall systems, etc. These are for atomic power plants, thermal power plants. For all those things also same procedure is to be adopted. A construction of not only seaport, hello, why are you going like that? The video is going on, why are you crossing all? You go this side, you do not have any sense at all, you go and sit there, sit that place. Seaport includes shipyards and other facilities also. The first step is to prepare a preliminary project report, that is also sometimes called as technical feasibility report. The developer needs a techno-economical report, feasibility report. So, these reports are prepared based on secondary data. Secondary data means whatever the data which is available, and general guidelines for cost estimate and other things. Typically, this should be prepared within a month's time. Once you prepare this technical feasibility report, there is a form, this is called as a form 1. This should be filled in along with, we have to give terms of reference. Terms of reference means what are all the studies that we are going to do, that has to be mentioned in that, and enclose this preliminary project report. Then we have to submit to the expert committee and they will review this, and then they will be giving additional terms of reference which may have to be carried out. Then we may also have to prepare a detailed project report with all these TOR what we have proposed, as well as the additional terms of reference specified by the committee. We have to carry out everything along with the detailed project report, which includes the cost estimate in a based on the site specific data. Then it goes into step 4. Is it clear? That is, you spell out some terms of reference, submit to the committee, it will review the terms of reference what you have submitted, it will specify additional terms of reference, and then you carry out all those things. One of the advantages, earlier in our MOEF, they never spell out what are the additional terms of reference. Every time you go to the meeting, they will go on adding additional terms of reference, they will ask you to do certain things more and things like that. But in this procedure, what is now formulated, you submit the preliminary project report, you submit the terms of reference what you are doing, they specify the additional terms of reference what is to be carried out, with that it becomes complete. So, what are all the things that are required normally in a terms of reference? CRZ classification. What is CRZ? You know what is CRZ? Coastal Regulation Zone. It is specified what are the activities that can 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, it is specified. LTL is low tide level and high tide level. And one of the problems in India is, suppose there is a doctor, he want to start a profession, so he undergoes some training, right. If it is a lawyer, he goes for apprenticeship. For engineer, nothing is required. Once you get the degree, you fellows are disturbing the video. Where is it required? Not in India. It is called as a professional engineer. It is required in many developed countries. Even in Malaysia, you need a license to do the, anybody with a bachelor degree in engineering, they can start the company here. That is not the case. I was telling the CRZ classification has to be done only by 7 authorized agencies, not by one and all. One of them is NIOT, which is in Chennai. Another is Institute of Remote Sensing in Anna University. The third one is NIO Goa. Like that, only agencies which have scientific manpower and equipment, they only can do. And risk analysis and disaster management, that also should be included. It is called as a terrestrial EIA study. what is terrestrial, what is marine? What is the difference between terrestrial and marine? On land is terrestrial, on water is marine. There is a accreditation council is there, National Board of Accreditation. Now they have accredited agencies which can do the terrestrial EIA. Only those agencies can do, not everybody can do. Marine EIA also they are doing it, but it is not yet completed. So this lacuna in anybody doing the work is now modified or changed completely, so that only the qualified agencies will do the work, that is the terrestrial EIA and rapid marine environmental impact assessment study. There are two types of studies that are in environmental. One is a rapid EIA study, another is a comprehensive. Rapid EIA means it is for one season. There are three seasons in India. One is northwest monsoon, northeast monsoon, southwest and non monsoon. One of these monsoons, if they do, that is called as a rapid EIA. Comprehensive nowadays they are asking for most of the project. The Sethu Samuthiram project, earlier they did not do the comprehensive, now they have been asked to do the comprehensive. Most of the atomic power plants, they want them to do the comprehensive EIA. There are some zones of accretion, some zones of erosion, which is already identified along the India map. Wherever the erosion rate is very high, more than 1 meter per year or something like that, then you have to do a comprehensive EIA study. We have to do a bathymetry survey, that is to find out the depth of water. Then the migration of olive turtle. Where are the olive turtles migrating in India? Which are the locations? Marina Beach. Then where else? There are certain locations in India which are very much used for migro olive turtle. None of you know. Have you seen olive turtle at least? Not in photograph at least. There is a coast in Orissa. There this olive, there is a river called Rishikulya River, north of the river. Mostly it is on the river bed. Marina is not the correct answer. It is the Adyar estuary where the olive turtles are coming. Especially on the estuary only these olive turtles come. How many eggs they lay, olive turtles? It is in hundreds or thousands. Nature is giving them enough protection. Even if the eggs are damaged, still it will come, but this has to be protected. Then again mangrove. What is mangrove? What is mangrove? In saline, it does not see mangroves, they grow only in the intertidal waters. Where are the mangroves in India? West Bengal. Which place it is called? Sundarbans. Where else? Andaman. Another place? Anybody from Tamil Nadu here? Raise your hand. Any place in Tamil Nadu? Pichavaram. Where is it? Near Chidambaram. There also we have mangroves. What is the advantage of these mangroves? During even tsunami, it protects the coastline from this. So, that is also. So, these are the two things that are to be considered. This olive turtles are in two rivers. One is the Mahanadi basin, that is that called as Bagudi Mahan, another is the Rishikulya River, then another is Adyar estuary also. There are other places also, but Orissa coast is more famous for this. Why do we have to provide olive turtle? What happens if it dies? Why should we worry about that? Contagious means? It is not a disease. I heard contagious. Endangered species, why should we protect that? How does it affect the ecosystem? Food chain. That is the correct answer. So it depends on the food chain. It is not only endangering this particular species, it will endanger the whole system also. Then disposal study of dredge material and it impacts on marine environment. Then shoreline evaluation study and littoral drift study. These are the studies that are to be carried out, very important studies, but some more studies are there, that is geotechnical study. Geotechnical means borehole investigation, site scan study, shallow seismic study. These are the two studies. These two studies can be done maybe in an area of 1 square kilometer. Each study may cost about 10 lakh rupees, whereas geotechnical studies will cost about 1 to 2 crores, borehole, marine borehole investigation. this is done in the DPR stage, whereas these two studies are done for most of the projects. When you go to the step 3 or step 4, public hearing, you know what is public hearing? Have you heard of it? Public hearing is a mandatory requirement. This is done by a district collector, where all the people go and the developer makes a presentation. It is videographed, just like today's lecture. This whole thing is videographed and it is kept as a documentation. It is done for major projects, whether it is atomic power plant, thermal power plant, whether it is a port facility, for anything we do this public hearing. The public hearing, all the public can go and make a representation also. Now, if they have some problem, they will say that we do not want the facility here. You know, one of the power plant was said that atomic power plant in Maharashtra, I think, based on the public opinion, they said they will not build that power plant at that location. Similarly, the Vedanta, they have some satellite that is there in Tuticorin port now, that industry was shifted from there. And they will say that certain remedial measures are to be done. They will also say that even in Kodangalam power plant, Tamil Nadu government has announced about 500 crores package for the people living nearby. The recent budget 150 crores has been given to them. So, they will tell what is that they need if the power plant comes at that location. Then we have to do the environmental impact on dredging activities, study on marine environment and construction of berths. We have also to discuss details of cargoes to be handled and their impacts on air, water and noise pollution due to such handling. Details of drainage system in berth and stockyard, of effluent treatment to treat the discharge runoff from the stockyard, details of monitoring program. So, there are two activities, one is the environmental impact assessment, another is the environmental management plan. The third one is the monitoring program. The monitoring program is normally done once in 6 months. There is a branch office for this MOE of Ministry of Environment and Forest at Bangalore. They take care of the southern region. So, the developer has to submit the monitoring plan, and when the project is executed, they have to submit a report. It can be monthly, bi-monthly or once in 6 months, depending on the data to be collected, that to be submitted. The future for any engineering activity is on environmental impact and management plan. So, without this, it is very difficult to carry out any project. So, suppose you are removing mangroves in certain areas, the Mumbai airport also, we have to remove certain areas mangroves. So, we have to go for mangrove plantation with action plan, with the expenditure being in the funds of the project development. What are the waste that are generated? What are the treatment facilities, including sewage treatment plant, especially for the desalination plants, as well as cooling water intake? There is an intake and outfall, where you have to dispose the outfall has to be done. That environmental management plan, what is the financial outlays that are proposed, that also has to be given. The water resources for construction and operation of project, and approval of competent authority for drawal of groundwater. Generally, it is not allowed to tap the groundwater. In Kerala, I think it is for Coca-Cola or Pepsi, they have been told not to draw the groundwater. In most of the marine projects, we do not allow them to tap any groundwater, they have to do the desalination only. This is another important aspect, that is the transportation of stones for breakwaters and groins and their impact. The quarry may be at a distance of 30 kilometer or 60 kilometer or 100 kilometer. So, if you transport these stones by trucks, whatever road you have laid, the road will not be in good condition. And the another problem is associated with the traffic generated, the pollution and other aspects also. And the quarries are another area of importance. There is a license given to the quarries, and how much can be removed from the quarry also has to be done. Details of reclamation, when you dredge it, you will reclaim on the land, and what is its impact on terrestrial ecology to be studied. And details of monitoring on impact of marine ecology and shoreline change during operation project, that is how the shoreline is changing, that also has to be measured and that also be reported. The step 3 and step 4 are not, you complete step 3 and then go for step 4. I have separated step 3 and step 4 as a step 3 for state government and step 4 for central government. So, both the state government and central government are required, they have to work together for implementing any project. State government is the final authority. It may look that the central government is the final authority, but it is not always the case. The state government has to, there is a state pollution control board, this gives the consent of establishment, then only they anybody can start the work. But this consent of for establishment will be given only after the central government gives the approval. Once the port has been established, before starting the work, the state government has to give the clearance for consent for operation. There are two agencies involved for both these things. One is the State Pollution Control Board, another is the Forest Department. Maybe you may not be aware of this State Forest Department. This is very important. There are areas where the Forest department has to give clearance. They give clearance for olive turtle, they give clearance for mangroves, they give clearance for any damage to the forestry and all those things. Pollution control board gives clearance for air, water, noise pollution, groundwater drawal, what happened to the shoreline and all those things. There is a Ministry of Environment in each state government. These people work under the control. Many of you may not be knowing, there is a chief secretary for any state government. The equivalent cadre in the police is Director General of Police. Both are of the equal ranks only. They are controlling any state government activity. Similarly, the State Pollution Control Board as well as the Forest Department, the topmost secretary or the IFS officers are in charge of the State Forest Department. So, both of them have equal responsibility and powers for this state government clearance. Next step is with the form 1, with the technical feasibility reports, with some of the studies, especially the CR research zone mapping based on the secondary data, what are all the things that is going on, all these things will be done. Then they will prepare the detailed project report. This may be repetition of what has been given earlier, but I will explain. They will give the meteorological and oceanographic data. Meteorological data is rainfall and other information. Oceanography is wave, tide, tsunami, things like that. Geotechnical is soil parameters. Topography means the topographical features of the area. The transport linkages, this also has to be done. Transport linkages, there are 4 linkages that is possible. Can you tell them what are the linkages transport? 4 I told, from the port to the hinterland. You name 1 or 2, railways, then roads, then air transport not including, then inland waterway, then what is the 4th one? Pipelines. These are the 4 linkages we have to study. Then we have to do the traffic study. This is very important. The traffic study is influenced both on the environment as well as the cost of the project. Then there are certain mathematical model studies that are being carried out. Most of the studies can be done in IIT Madras. The wave tranquility studies to find out what will be the wave inside a harbor basin. Sedimentation studies. If there are some people with the M.Tech Ocean Engineering or B.Tech Naval Architecture, they can study the navigation simulation. That means when the ship is coming near the port, we stop the engine, attach tugboats and then bring the vessel inside. That also can be done numerically. Then disposal study of dredging materials, how much time it takes for the sediment which is disposed to settle, how much area it is covered, all these things can be done in a mathematical model study. Each study is approximately varying between 5 lakhs to 10 lakh rupees, each one of these studies. There are standard software packages available. The cost of the software is totally different, but many agencies can do the study, qualified agencies. Many means it is not more than a dozen within India. Maybe I will do it in the next class.